It was another exciting year ahead for all of us. It was the beginning of the new session. Yes, I felt great to see all my students back again. Since there were new members who had joined us that year, we all had to start with our introductions. I was the first one to begin with the introduction. And then there was a flood of introductions in the class. Just then, Arun got up to introduce himself. He sounded very low. And you know what he said? He just said, "My name is Arun. I study in 7th B. And that is all about me." Stating this, he sat down soon. Just then, suddenly, there was a voice inquiring, "Hey Arun, how were your holidays?" To my surprise, the child replied promptly. He said, "Please mind your own business. I don't think it is necessary to share it with you." As his teacher, I could not digest the fact he did not want to interact with any of us. He did not want to mingle around with anyone. I tried to talk to him a number of times, but he disliked it. Once, in the lunch break, when I asked him, "Who is your best friend?" he told me, "Nobody." When I asked him the reason for not having any friend in the class, he told me, "I don't know." I could feel the child is very lonely. It was not easy, as it appeared to be, to gain the child's confidence. But one final day, yes, I made it. I gained the confidence of the child. And you know what? He came and shared the reason of being sad. Can you guess what he told me? He told me his parents feel he was good for nothing. The expectations from the child was very high. This really left a deep impact on the tender mind. He developed the apprehension of being judged by others. Not only this, the way he was treated at home, he started treating everybody in the school. He really became harsh and rude to his friends. When I told him to go and apologize, he refused. He ignored me. But my efforts did not come to an end. I did try, and I succeeded in talking to the child and made him realize that I care for you. I was so happy to understand he could not accept the fact that others were doing better than him, as he always wanted to see himself acquiring the first position. I remember once when his team had lost the match, he was very upset the entire day. When I observed, I spoke to him. I made him realize that, see, failures are the key to success. You need not worry. We learn through our mistakes. I feel he was okay after talking to me. That was the time I felt, yes, he has developed his confidence in me too. I still can cherish the memory when one day he had brought a handmade card for me on my birthday to let me feel special. I still remember that he was so happy while handing that card over to me. I can cherish the moment when I appointed Arun as the leader of the class. He started taking initiatives. He started participating in the activities. He was so enthusiastic. I was so happy to see him. Not only this, he trusted me. And one day, he brought a handmade card for me on my birthday. That was very shocking for me because I never expected that from Arun. Arun was really glad to give me that card. At least that sweet gesture of his made me feel valuable that day. I could see Arun now mingling with the classmates. He even brought extra food for all the children in the class. He started sharing his food. that was the best day of my life. Believe me, I felt great and wonderful that day because Arun was happy. I said to myself, thank God. God bless the child. May Arun be the same way always. Thank you.